The video you're currently watching is being streamed from my smartphone and is connected to OBS using SRT. This means that you can easily import your phone camera to any live streaming software that supports SRT. Not just limited to OBS and VMix alone, with this application, the possibility for live streaming are endless. And the name is called OmniStream. This is your first time of hearing the name OmniStream. Come close, and if you've ever heard of it before, in this particular video, I want to show you how you can be able to import your phone camera to OBS, to VMix, to Prism Live using SRT. The first thing that you're going to do is to head over to Play Store, where you need to install the OmniStream application. The one that has the OS with the video icon inside of it, this is the particular one that you need to install. Once you're done installing the app, go ahead and open it. Now, you can see the choose your language option there. That is if you don't understand English, you can choose your various language based on the flag that is displayed on the screen. Leave a link in the description of this particular video where I explain the step-by-step guide on how you can sign up for a free account. Click on login, and I'm going to log in the OmniStream application. Now, once you open the application, this is how it's going to look like, and let me show you how to set up the SRT. Okay, now the last thing that you're going to do is to click on the arrow at the top left there, this arrow icon there. Click on it, and you're going to see a bunch of different tab here, the export configuration. Over here, you have the Facebook, the YouTube, the Twitch. And if you look down there, you're going to see the SRT listener, SRT caller, and also the custom RTMP. Remember, we're going to be using the SRT listener. I'm just going to delete this one that I previously created. So click on the SRT listener down there. And you can see here on the stream host, there's nothing there. On the port, there's nothing there. And also on the passphrase, there's nothing there as well. Just click on the generate button there at the bottom here. Click on generate to generate the stream host, the port, and also the passphrase. Save and close. And once you're done, you can see the SRT listener has been successfully created. You can click on the share button here to copy that. But if you don't want to do that, you all want to open it on your system. They also have a web application for that. Let's go ahead and log into the web application. Don't forget your company name is same as the email address that you use to sign up. Click on the login here, and this is how it's going to look like. On the list of devices, you're going to see all the devices that is connected to your OmniStream application. So you're going to see all of them here. It's currently connected to my phone because I'm logged in on the app on my phone. Now, over here at the left, you see the stream and the export tab. And we're going to click on the export tab. And from the export tab, you're going to see the SRT listener. Now, just take a look. This is the SRT listener that we created on the mobile app. And you can see it listed here on the web application. Remember, you could use this for any version of VMix at all, be VMix 27, 26, 25, 23, 21, any version of VMix at all, it will work perfectly fine for you. And also remember, do not block the VMix software through the firewall or through the host file, okay, so that the SRT signal will be sent directly on your VMix software, okay? Just click on the add input here at the bottom left here. Click on the add input. And once you've done that, go over to the stream and SRT here. And on the stream and SRT, at the top here, you see the stream type. Click on that and select SRT caller. Remember, we selected SRT listener on the OmniStream application. Select the caller there. On the host name, open the web application and copy the stream host here. Go back to the VMix software and paste it on the host name. And back again on the port here, copy the port. Open the VMix software again and paste it on the port here. Paste that. And once you paste it on the port here, go over to the web application again and copy the passphrase also. Once you've copied the passphrase, open the VMix software again and paste it here on the passphrase. Once you're done, you can play around with the latency a bit. Just you can increase the number, you can reduce the number depending on the type of network you're using over there. You put it on 400, 300, 800, just play around the number to get a perfect thing. Because you already selected all of this, just leave the key length, the audio track, or leave every other thing the way it is and click on OK. You can see here, nothing is currently showing on the VMix software. The next thing you're going to do is to open the OmniStream app, okay? So I'm just going to close this here. On the app, let me show you how to set up the video quality you're sending out through SRT, the video quality, the video bitrate, the camera source, and also the video codec. And let me show you all the settings, how you can be able to do that from the mobile app. Now, on the app here on my screen, you can see at the top there, it's written 3 MB there. Click on it, and this is where you set the video bitrate. You see 1, 2, all the way to 16 and 12 and 8 there on the screen. This is where you set a video bitrate that you want to send out to SRT. Very important, before we set the video bitrate, let's run a speed test on the internet to find what number it supports, okay? And for you to run a speed test on your internet to find the perfect bitrate that you could use, what you have to do is to click on this three-dot line there at the top left, click on that, and then go over to speed test. Click on the speed test here. I could see right there on the screen, speed test in progress. Now, what this app does is going to analyze your internet and give you a number, specific number that your network supports. Once it has finished analyzing your network, if you have a Wi-Fi connected, it's also going to analyze that. And if you have your phone cellular data on as well, it's also going to analyze that. And from my pen here, you see no broadcast issues have been found. Total bitrate is 5, requested bitrate is 3. Now, if you take a look down, you see a Wi-Fi, is sent connection, measured bitrate is 2.1, and also my phone cellular here, measured bitrate is 2.87. Don't be scared if you get issues like this. Just like the one you see right there on the screen, where it says some issues we have found. It will also give you a guide on how you can be able to fix it. Now, if you take a look at there, you see some issues we have found. Total bitrate is 4.67. Requested bitrate is 3. Now, on the phone cellular data, it says good connections. Measured bitrate is 2.9. And then on the Wi-Fi, you see warning, no bandwidth on carrier. Now, measured bitrate is 1.7. It said the Wi-Fi, you shouldn't use it alone. Okay. And that is it there. It just gives you a recommendation on how you could also be able to fix a problem. Once you've seen the video bitrate your network support, please make sure you stay within that range, or rather you could lower the number. Okay. So that you won't have any issue at all. If your video bitrate support 5, please, you can reduce it to either 2 or 3, but don't increase it to 8 or 12, okay? Because your internet does not support higher video bitrate. But if you do, you could play around with the number also, but just make sure you stay within that range. And when I close this, if you take a look at the bottom left here, you're going to see 2 out of 2. That is because my phone is connected to a Wi-Fi and my phone cellular data is also on as well. And the OmniStream mobile app have helped to bond the two networks together. How do you set this bonding feature on, or turn it on rather, on your own mobile device? So when you connect the Wi-Fi to your phone, you could also bond that with your phone cellular data. For you to be able to do this, all you have to do is to click this three-dot line here and go over to settings. Now on the settings here, scroll down till you see transport. On the transport, you see the network interface there. Click on it. And make sure it's on Wi-Fi plus cellular. Now, if it's on cellular, even if you connect a Wi-Fi, it's not going to bond. If it's on Wi-Fi, even if you're on your phone cellular, it's not going to bond. Make sure it's on Wi-Fi plus cellular, and that will enable it to bond the two networks together. If you take a look at the top right here, you see the video icon. Click on that, and from here, you can be able to select the camera source. When you click on the camera source, you see the internal back, internal front, the Omni Capture, which I'm also going to make a video on. And you see the last one there, this is the kilo view, so you don't have anything to do with that. From here, you can set if you want to use the front camera of your phone, or if you want to use the back camera of your phone. And also by the side of it, you see the resolution there. Now you can scale up this resolution, you can reduce this resolution depending on what you want. Now they've given you an option on the app, you can scale up to 4K, full HD, depending on what you want. You can see they've given you different frame rate with different resolution, so you can select anyone at all that you want to, but I don't advise scaling up to 4K if your phone does not support 4K. Also by the side of it, you see the video, the codec type there. This is where you select the video codec, and I'm giving you two codecs to select from. That is the HEVC and also the MPEG-4. So you can actually select the particular one that you want to make use of. Now let me just go ahead and click on the video icon again. The bottom right here, you're also going to see the mic icon. This is where you turn on the mic. So if you have any external mic connected to your phone, you'll also be able to see that on the screen. You'll be able to select that because it's going to bring it to you as a list of mic that you can connect. I muted the mic on my phone because I didn't want an echo at the end of this tutorial. Okay, once you're done with all the settings, the next thing you're going to do is go ahead and click on the live button at the center there. As you can see that the video is currently playing on the screen on Vimeo, and you can see the resolution there. Also going to see how clean it's going to look on the screen, and this is how you can be able to connect it on Vimeo. Now let me also go ahead and show you how you can link it up through SRT, the OBS, and also Prism Live. To link it up with OBS, all you have to do is to open the mobile app again, you just click on that arrow sign there, the icon there at the top left. Now from here, click on the SRT listener. Now click on generate here again, and it's going to generate that. Save and close. And you could copy the link here from here. We just copy the link from here. But if you don't want to copy the link from here, just open the web application, go over to export, and from the SRT here, at the top here, you're going to see the copy icon there. See the copy icon there? You could just also copy it from here if you don't want to copy it from their mobile app. Just copy it from here, and it's going to pop up a new screen saying vimin/OBS. Click on the vimin/OBS to copy the link. Open your OBS software. Click on the plus icon there on the OBS software, the plus icon, click on that, and then go over to media source. See the media source here, click on the media source, and from here, could name your media source anything you want. Once you're done, click on OK, and from here, untick the local file, very, very important, untick that, and on the input tab, paste the link, the SRT link that you just copied, just leave every other thing the way it is, and once you're done, click on OK. Now place your mouse on the media source, right click, and go over to transform. From transform here, select fit to screen. Very important, fit to screen, and that will bring that on the screen. Now you can see currently nothing is showing here. Once you successfully done this, open the mobile app and click on the live button at the center of the screen. Now if you don't want to click on the live button from here, you could also open the web application. Just open the web application and then click on this play button here, see. On the video, this the here, just click on this thing that looks like a play button here. See there, just click on that. And once you click on it, that will turn the live option on from your phone. You can see there, that will turn that option on. On the OBS, you could see how the video looks like. You could see the quality of the video there on the screen. This is how it looks like, okay? And this is how to send it through OBS. To set this up on Prism Live, same process as the OBS one. Now I've showed you how to set up the video bitrate, your video resolution, your camera source, and also your network, how to increase that, turn on and also off the mic, zoom in and out of your shot. And this is how you can also set this up and send it through SRT to the Prism Live studio. Click on that arrow icon there at the top left, click on that. Then from here, select SRT listener. Then click on generate. That will give you all the SRT information, the stream host, the ports, and also the passphrase. Click on save and close. And this is the SRT listener link that we've just created. Now you could copy it from here, but you can also copy it from the web application. So let me show you how to do that from the web application. From here, if you want to copy, just click on the share button there. You'll see the vimin/OBS copy URL. So you can just click on the vimin/OBS copy the URL. Go over to the web application. You see the copy icon there. That's on there. Oh, just click on that. A new window is going to pop up in OBS/Vimin. So Vimin/OBS. Click on that particular one to copy the link. Go ahead and open Prism Live on your system. Okay. Once the Prism Live is up already, so click on this plus icon there. Click on that and then go over to media source. Okay. Click on the media source. Select that and click on OK. Now you can name your media source anything, and once you're done, click on OK again and untick this local file here. Very important, untick that, and then you see this input tab here. Right click and paste, and just paste the SRT link that we've copied here. This is where you paste the SRT link. And once you're done, click on OK again. Place your mouse on the media source, right click, and go over to transform. From the transform here, select fit to screen, very important, and that will bring that on full screen, okay? And once you already selected this, the next thing you're going to do is either you open the mobile app and click on the live button at the center of the screen here to transmit the SRT signal from the phone to the system, or you open the web application and then click on this play button here. Yeah, this play button here, this is another way to do that. Click on this play button here, and that will turn on the live tab at the center of your phone screen, okay? So click on this one here, that will start to send the signal from your phone down to the system, either the Vimin, the OBS, or the Prism Live, depending on whichever one you're using. If you take a look at the phone screen, you could see right there, this is where you'll be able to see the two networks that have been bonded together. If you click on this, the chat there beside the three dot line on the top, you'll be able to see the two signal being bonded together. So you see how many percent is coming from this, and also how many percent is coming from this as well. Take a look at that right there. You can see this video signal coming from the phone all the way to the Prism Live Studio through SRT. Okay, as you can see there on the screen currently, and move around with this, use it, video around everything you want to. You can see there. I use it to video around the OmniStream Live Player. Just this small box you could see right there on the screen is where you see what is being sent out. Okay, what you're sending out through SRT on the small box is where you see that. You can see it there on the small box. That is where you see it. Now also at the top right there, you're going to see this that looks like a chart. This here, click on it, and from here you could see what ratio is coming in from your phone cellular and the Wi-Fi connected to your phone. From here you can see the number fluctuating from 86, this one, to 25, to 32. So 77% or 84% rather coming in from our phone cellular data, and then 23 or 15% is coming from the Wi-Fi connected to my phone. You can see here it have bonded the two of them together, showing you which ratio is coming in from my Wi-Fi and what ratio is also coming in from my phone cellular data. This is how to link your phone to VMAs, OBS, Prism Live through SRT.